Our first guest is an old friend of ours and certainly one of the funniest men we know. He has written a brand new book right here. It's called Pure Drivel, and it's in stores right now. Do me a favor, please welcome the always entertaining Steve Martin. Steve!
Boy, that's a great way to kill time.
Nah. It's a great ovation for a great guy. You deserve
it. Thanks. You said I was an old friend of the show.
Well, I like to think you'd be in those terms.
Yeah, well, thank you.
You know, I was talking to some people, and they said...
Oh, I bet you were. As opposed to what?
Ants.
A door.
And they said that, and forgive me if this is inaccurate, it very well could be, that they have seen you from time to time in Central Park on a bicycle.
Oh, yes.
Is that true?
Yeah, I love to ride a bicycle.
I didn't know that about you.
Yeah, I started riding a bicycle a long time ago. I was, you know, I used to exercise, and I would sit on a stationary bike, you know, and I was pedaling, and I thought, what am I doing?
Yeah.
So I got a regular bike, and I love it. Ride up hills for long ways, right. And I ride
it. It's good.
Park.
You feel it right here in your upper legs.
Yeah.
It really starts to burn, and it's a great aerobic exercise as well.
And, I don't ride that kind of bike.
Well, you don't ride that kind of bike.
No. I don't know. I'm going nowhere. But I, what you do is you get out among the people.
Right.
You know, for celebrities, it's hard to be out among the people without sort of being...
Is that trouble for you?
You know, some on the bike that you get to whiz by, like... Labor Day,
right.
You know, it was a beautiful day. I was here. It was in Central Park. It was sunny. It was bright. And people were in strollers and babies and happy families and people in Frisbees. And I rode through the park, and I noticed, like, three 14-year-old kids, and they were troublemakers. They were, swearing real loud. And I was going, oh, no.
They were taunting people.
They were taunting people and riding up behind people and scaring old ladies, or elderly ladies. Yeah. And he was saying, yeah! And I thought, oh, I hate these guys. I just hate it. It's so beautiful. I hope they don't see me. Yeah. So I keep riding. And finally, one of them, he doesn't know it's me. And he comes up behind me and goes, yeah, like this. And I look at him and I go, screw you.
Good for you. Good for you.
And so he looks at me and he goes, hey, it's Steve Martin, you know. Now he follows me to the park. It's Steve Martin, everybody.
That's annoying.
Yeah, I'm like this. Yeah. So now I go, now it's 2 days later. It's night. It's balmy night. It's a beautiful night. I'm walking around New York with a friend. And this 15-year-old girl comes up to me and says, hey, remember the guy you said screw you to in the park? I'm his sister.
You can't win.
Yeah.
You just can't win. Let's talk about the book. I'm very excited.
Sure.
And I've been reading your book since I got a copy earlier this week, and it's very good.
Oh, thank you.
It's
very,
little essays, little pieces of humor.
Yes.
Very, very funny stuff.
Thank you.
And it's, I guess, in stores right now.
Oh.
Pure Drivel.
What?
Pure Drivel.
My God. It was supposed to be Pure Drive. I told them. I should have proofread it. Hey, want me to, that's your copy?
Yeah.
Let me sign that for you.
You know, I didn't want to embarrass you. Thank you very much.
I'd
love
you
to sign it.
I could see it in your face that you wanted me to sign it.
I did. I actually did.
Okay.
I'm really enjoying it.
Here we go. So, dear...
Dave.
Okay. I love being your friend because you earn so much money. I would love it if you would buy me a car. Would it be okay if I had sex with your girlfriend? I'll sign in. There you go.
That's very nice. Thank you very much. I'll treasure that.
It's okay.
That's very
You don't have to treasure it. It's, now, probably to save... To save the audience time, what I've done is, I know you want to buy the book and you want to read it, but to go to the trouble and analyze it afterwards, which is what you have to do, I've already broken it down for you. So if you do have a, we have a chart here.
I don't know what this is.
Thank you.
Now this is like a reading aid, a reading
reading
guide.
Aid that we'll show you. Do I hold this? Or
yeah, here, I'll hold it up
okay.
for the writer.
You know how to do that.
Sure.
It just has pages 312, 24 through 35 are hilarious.
Uh-huh. I see.
That's
because
I was in a great mood.
That's right,
when I
wrote
those. Then we have these pages. They are pretty funny.
Uh-huh.
And that's because...
What? I saw that. Go ahead.
Yeah, I accidentally drank liquid paper. And here we have some other pages that are so-so. And that's because I was talking to Monica. And then, of course, these few pages here suck. Because I wrote them while sitting naked on... on an oscillating fan.
Really?
Yes.
You do that when you're right.
Yes, but I'm not doing that anymore.
No, I wouldn't do that.
Because the pages suck.
Yeah.
So, if they had been at the top, hilarious, I would have done
sure.
that at the top.
But that's a technique you implored while writing.
Absolutely. It's Hemingway did it, actually.
I didn't know that. Mm-hmm. Sat naked on an oscillating fan.
Yeah.
I'll be darned.
You will?
Yeah. You can hang around here a little bit. We got a lot of other
I'd
stuff
love
to talk
around.
About. Good to see you, Steve.
Hey,
thanks
fun.
For coming by. We'll be right back here with our friend Steve Martin.
Such a name.
Take a look at that. My gosh.
Isn't that beautiful?
Oh, yeah. That's nice. The planes, of course, are now landing right there in Central Park.
That's it. Now, that's New York City or is that L.A.?
No, that was New York.
Uh-huh. I don't get around very much.
It's good to have you on the program, and it's always nice to see you. And the book is very, very funny.
Thanks.
I really appreciate it.
I must say, it is a little... Well, it feels funny to be back, actually.
You know, it's been a while.
It's been about almost 3 years.
Yeah.
And, you know.
I know. But, I mean, it's been okay, though.
Yeah.
I mean, I was jumpy as well.
Yeah, still. But after what happened last time, I mean, it was strange.
I guess that's a way to look at it. It was strange, I suppose. That's one way to look at it. But the important thing is that, you know, we've come through that and you're back.
But
and it's good.
You remember what happened.
Oh, Dave.
Hey, Steve.
Yeah. Good show.
Yeah. You were great. Thank you very much.
Thank you. You were good, too.
No.
No, you set me up great.
No, the audience loved you, I thought.
They were a good audience.
Yeah, because of you, you know? Yeah. Seriously.
Well, you doing okay?
I'm fine.
Yeah.
I'm fine. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Well, I guess I better go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, you know, I have to go, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice.
sister.
I love the
Hey, Dave.
Oh, hi.
How are you doing? Good to see you.
Good to see you.
This is Catherine.
Hi.
How do you do, Catherine? Hi. This is Nadine.
Hi, Nadine.
Catherine. Hi, how are you?
Hi. Nice
well,
to meet you.
It's good to see you.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Yeah.
Section enjoyed it. Well, that was something, wasn't
yeah,
it?
That's how it went down.
Yeah. Well, listen.
Okay. I will.
Have a great holiday season. We got holidays coming up, I guess, right?
Name one. Halloween.
Halloween. There
oh,
you go.
Yeah. Hey, maybe we can go out.
The book is Pure Drivel. This, of course, is Steve Martin.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Steve.
Bye.
Nice to have you. Steve Martin. We'll be right back with Sophie Roberts.